David, were you able to come up with an answer to this question?
So I started with the slots that we listed earlier. So for our subject, we now have Angela. For our object, we now have lasagna. This time we have a location. Our location is Olive Garden. Our time is night. We weren't given utensils, and we weren't really given anything to suggest that the object is still alive, or that the object is not in the subject, or that the subject isn't happier having eaten dinner. We probably could have put some more information in here as well. So for example, we could have put her dad in here in some way, but we haven't yet looked at the slot that would take care of that.
That's a very good answer, David. First of all, the answer is correct. And in addition, you were able to point out that there is no slot here which is able to take care of the information coming in as input about her dad. Before we worry about what to do about the information that Angela had lasagna with her dad, let us look at some other properties of frames. So once again, there are slots. You can put fillers for each of the slots. Each filler may come from a range of values. Some of the slots have default fillers. Now you can see how some kind of common sense inferences become possible. Some of them become possible from these default fillers for the slots. So for example, when we said Ashok ate a frog, and David answered the question whether the frog was dead or alive by saying the frog was dead. Well, we know about it because there is a default value here. The object that is being eaten is not alive. It's false to say it's alive. And the location of the object after it has been eaten is inside the subject's stomach or inside the subject's body, and so on. We could put here more slots with more default values for them. Once again, we'll discuss a lot more about common sense reasoning a little bit later in this particular course. For now, we are trying to understand the knowledge representation of frames.